its circumference might be slightly on the larger side, but still within the normal range for individuals with deletions. The duplications, they have size that is kind of smack in the middle, so very much average for age. Individuals with duplications still have evidence of spinal curves, so things like scoliosis. And usually things like this can relate to two problems. One is the one earlier when I talked about actual problems with spinal formation. And then the other one is if somebody has weak muscles in their torso, and what we call the axial muscles, from that kind of hypotonia, then that can cause secondary curvature of the spine. And so we're seeing a lot of that. Even though some of these things are more common in deletions, they're still present in the duplication. So, for instance, there is still a real number, but it's a lot smaller than there's duplications with speech and articulation abnormalities. But some of these other features, like again, the hypotonia and the deep tendon reflexes and the gait abnormalities, were essentially similar in the sense that a percentage of both deletions and duplications had issues with that. Individuals with duplications, although a small number, 4 out of the first 40 that we took a look at, did have some what we would call clinically ataxia, meaning that they were unsteady when they were walking. And then these are findings that, again, are instead of from the neurological history, sorry, from the neurologic exam, these are from the neurological history. So when the parents are being interviewed by the genetic counselors, again, supporting this diagnosis of both clumsiness and hypotonia. And for the clumsiness, we hope to get more information when we completed this movement ABC test. And then again, seizures are present in a very small percentage of the duplication, and this number is too small for me to say whether this is above the normal rate for kids in the general population, because it's just 3 individuals. So I would say stay tuned right now. I would just say that looks to me like it's about at the same rate that you see for kids in the general population. And then again, we did imaging on both deletion and duplication individuals. And so 31 of the individuals have duplications. And then that was compared against, again, the relatives who came in. And we found, like in the deletion individuals, we found an abnormality at the base of the skull. This sort of, it appears that in both the deletion and the duplication, there seems to be some issue with bone formation, and the base of the skull in particular seems to be a susceptible spot for that. And then another thing that we saw that we didn't really see so much in the deletions was we saw enlarged ventricles. Now, this doesn't mean that there was hydrocephalus, which means that there's pressure, but rather to us it suggests that the volume of this area that we call the white band, which in this picture here is actually white, is smaller in volume than in a comparison control individual. So you can see here, so this would be the front of the head, this would be the back of the head, this is the right side, and this is the left side, and so it's as if you're taking a slice like this through the brains, the same way these two MRI slices, and this is an individual who's a duplication carrier who has this area here where the ventricles, which are these fluid-filled sacs in the middle of the brain, and they are enlarged relative to an individual who is a family control member. And so we saw